Hello, today we'll be doing a live demo of the ADA plugin for WordPress. I'll be walking you through the plugin, showing you how it works, but more importantly showing you the incredible value and efficiency this is going to bring to your organization when it comes to not just building but maintaining ADA compliance and accessibility over time. Now, a quick note, today's training is going to be about showing you how to use the plugin. I won't be spending much time talking about specific ADA requirements and how to make your website compliant. We have great resources for that, though. If you visit our website at adaplugin.com, we'll be providing resources and tutorials and training on teaching you how to make your sites compliant. Now, the first thing you'll do once you install your plugin is check out the tab in your dashboard called Accessibility. There it is right there. First, let's look at the guidelines. Now, in my opinion, we have put together the definitive list of guidelines for ADA compliance, spent months researching government websites trying to put together a definitive list of accessibility requirements, and I think we've done it. This is exhaustive. This list is really detailed. It's got a lot of great information for you. It's not overwhelming, though, and let me explain. What we do is we break ADA guidelines into consumable chunks here. You'll see here's the specific guideline chapter number, the specific guideline text, and below that we describe how the plugin will help you meet that guideline, which is really wonderful. Now let's run a scan. So down here we have start scan in the lower left. You can title your scan anything you want. By default, it just gives the day's date, which is good enough for this demonstration. You can set your scan to manually run. You can set your scan to manually run at any time using the Start Scan button, or you can set automated recurring scans, monthly, quarterly, twice a year, or yearly. Okay, we're just going to do a one-time scan today. Now, the first thing the plugin does is it scans and audits your website. Note, if you have a big website, this is going to take several minutes, but that's okay. We've built some intelligence into the plugin. You can actually leave this screen while the plugin is actively scanning, come back later when the scan is ready for you. Okay? Let me describe these three boxes here. The left box outlines your overall progress to finishing the checklist and scan. The middle box describes where we're at right now and what's being done. The far right box will show progress, and in a moment it will give some details. Okay? So the first thing we need to do now that the scan is done is review images. This plugin will automatically pull up image files that don't have alt text descriptions. You don't have to scour your media library, which of course takes up a ton of time. It can be done right here. And we need to describe our photo with an alt text description. Reminder, alt text is plain English sentences that are very descriptive. So I'm going to say photo of a full red box. And just for speed, green box and a blue box. And those are my images that need to get fixed. Pretty easy. We'll save and continue. You'll see we're on step 4 of 5 now. We're reviewing other data, specifically the collected objects, to make sure they are accessible. This is the biggest part of the scan. It has 9 parts to it. Now you'll notice each part tells us where we're at, 1 of 9. It gives us the requirements relevant to this part with links back to the guidelines, and then some plain text, layman term help text that should help you point in the right direction. So, media files is the first thing that we're looking at. The plugin has found 2 media files. I've identified that they're PDF documents, okay? And so I can either mark this as compliant if I know that they're already compliant. I can ignore them on this scan with some information of why I'm ignoring them. Or I can go investigate this file, which I'll do in a new tab, which takes me right to the entry. where I will witness that this PDF file comes with no caption or description. Now, naturally, your PDF files need to at least have alt text captions and descriptions. Even better yet, they should have a transcript either here in the description or on your web page. Okay. Now, for the sake of demoing the plugin, I'm just going to mark these as compliant so we can keep moving. The next part of the scan looks at tables. Now, tables are really tricky. Tables historically are very difficult to be made compliant, but we've made it very easy. Okay? Assistive devices need help identifying column and row headers of your tables. Ensure your tables are using the proper TH elements to identify headers, or use more advanced methods described in 1194.22H. Of course, we give you a link back to that guideline. Here are our three tables that have been found that need to be fixed. So again, I can just open in a new tab to that table. Here's the table. We can see here's the visual mode and the text mode, and we just need to fix some of that HTML markup. Very simple, even a non-developer can do that. Again, for the sake of time, we're going to just mark these as compliant, like I've fixed them, and we'll continue. The next part is image tags, okay? These images are not from your media gallery, so we cannot add alt text automatically. You will need to add alt text to these images manually. So this is a great example of a complexity of ADA compliance and how this plugin will help you identify these very quickly so that you can fix them. Okay. So here we have an image, a couple images actually, one here. We also have a logo file here. These are often coming hard-coded from third-party sources, which is pretty common. And so to fix these, of course, we need to go into the HTML and add the appropriate alt text description. Again, today is not about what to do to become compliant. We're showcasing the plugin. So again, we'll mark this as compliant and we'll go to the next. Great. Next is iframes, another complex part of compliance. The plugin will find all of the iframes embedded on your site with direct links to where they are. We also see some initial code. Ensure these iframes have an accurate title tag that facilitates frame identification and navigation. So again, just a quick HTML fix. We'll mark these as compliant and we'll save and continue. The next part of the scan looks at video files. Video files, either embedded directly or from a third-party source. Now, videos must have suitable alt text, such as subtitles or captions, or a transcript. Also ensure that your videos do not exhibit excessive flickering. Now, this is where the plugin will put us in the right direction in terms of a time savings. Some things about video compliance you'll need to do on your own. For example, adding captions or subtitles to bake into the video file itself. However, there are some on-page things you should also consider. For example, a plain text transcript of the video file. Of course, this takes us right to the page with said video where I can add my transcript. Of course, we have several videos here to demonstrate and be on my way. So we'll mark as compliant. Keep going. Next, the plugin will identify any audio files. You can open in a new tab, identify what's going on, and very quickly fix. Okay. So here's a page with our audio file. Here's our code here. Just for fun, let's pretend like we're ignoring this item. Next part of the plugin here looks at objects. Now this is kind of a catch-all, and it may even be a repeat of what's been found before. Okay, object tags can include many types of information such as video, audio, or content from another website. Okay, so again, we link back to the guidelines, and we also link to any objects that have been found in your website. We'll mark this as compliant, and we'll move on to object or to sections 8 and 9 here. Embed tags. Again, we identify the source, which you can then go fix. And then finally, forms. Forms should be navigable with assistive technologies. You should ensure that your forms are navigable with the keyboard at minimum. And what this means is, of course, clicking tab to move on to the next section. Okay. And so the website will find all forms embedded in your website that may have issues and then give you appropriate linkage to go get them fixed. And let's go in and finish our scan. The last part is our self-assessment compliance checklist. And this is more about getting you into a habit to recognize and acknowledge that these things have been resolved. Okay? So now we point back to all of these guidelines with a reminder of the specific requirement, and then in layman's terms, what you should be doing to ensure compliance. And so for speed's sake, we're just going to agree to all of these. Done. Then we'll save and continue. Wonderful. Scan completed. Congratulations, the scan has been completed on September 19th, 2017. Some descriptive text there. Now we can go back to scan results. There will be a logged copy of the scan for your records. I hope that you enjoyed this demo, and I'm really excited for you to get this plugin, get it on your website, and start actively making your site accessible per the 508 federal guidelines. Have a great day.